welcome again to another episode of The Wheel of the Year. I'm Harmony Frenterhouse, and today this episode is all about how to celebrate the amazing festival of Lamas or Lunasan. This festival is celebrated on or around the time of August 1st. It's the midpoint between the summer solstice and the autumn equinox, and it's really a celebration of the sun and of the energies of the harvest and the gratitude that we hold for the energies of the harvest. So this video is 8 ways to celebrate the amazing celebration of Lamas. So join me and we'll talk all about how I like to celebrate, and you can leave comments down below about how you like to celebrate it if I forgot something that you guys like to do as well. Number one, get out in nature. Get out and harvest, and get out in your garden and do nature walks, wildcraft, and if you're unable to do that, go to a farmer's market. Get outside in the air and support the local wildcrafted, grown, organically produced, amazing foods that you can get at the farmer's markets. All the produce, all of the grains and the breads, and it's just an amazing time of year to celebrate the great harvest. And so another way, number two, the second way you can celebrate this time of year is by making an altar. And this altar can be elaborate, very small, indoors, outdoors, you can make many of them. It's a really great way to bring that energy into a solid form and really have a place to reflect upon as you celebrate this time of the year. So this altar, you can decorate it with all sorts of things that you've gathered from nature, from the farmer's markets, from your garden, the produce, the flowers, crystals, incense, plants, herbs, all those wonderful things. Decorate your altar, make it a sacred space, and really enjoy this time of the year as you do so. Anything goes as long as it symbolizes the energies that are surrounding us at this time. Number three is create corn dollies, corn maidens. Corn maidens are so wonderful for this time of year, being that it's the first of the three great harvests of the grain. We are starting to see corn form, and the corn maiden is honored in the wonderful way of making corn maidens or corn dollies. And this is a great way to decorate your altar. You can do some spell work with it in the fire or burying them, speaking your intentions as you creating these dollies are a really great way to anchor in that abundance and gratitude that you feel for this time of year. Number four is sunflower magic. Sunflowers are really, really powerful at this time of the year, especially being that the sun is at its peak, the days are warm, it's just beautiful, and the sunflowers are blooming. So sunflower magic is a great way to incorporate all of the sun and all of the warmth and the abundance and growth all around you during this time. There's sacred geometry and the patterns of the way that the seeds grow, and you can make wishes as you count the different seeds and or as you dry them and you harvest the seeds. It's really just a great symbolic way to anchor in those energies of manifestation and planting seeds and harvesting. Number five, bake and feast. Baking and feasting is what we do at this time of the year. We celebrate all the abundance around us. We make bread and wine and all the delicious things, kombuchas and wonderful fruit juices and salads. And it's really the time for the great communion, breaking the bread and the wine. I believe comes from the time of Lunasa, of Lamas, and it is the time for celebrating the goddess, the god, all of the great divine within us all and all around us in every form. Number six is to have a gratitude jar or gratitude tree. It is a really fun way to celebrate this time of year, being that we're in so much abundance, to really celebrate gratitude, count your blessings, write them down, hang them from a tree in your garden, or put them in a jar, and then reflect upon those come the next quarter mark upon the wheel. And that will be the autumn equinox. And we'll pull those out again, and we'll be able to really reflect and count our blessings and all the things that we're grateful for. Number 7 is working with crystals and creating a crystal grid. So, being that it is a wonderful time to be in our gardens, create crystal grids in your garden, blessing in abundance and amplifying the energies and manifestation. You can make crystal grids on your altar. You can make crystal grids all over. And they're really fun to create. And not only that, they're amplifying in your energy. Quartz, if you do the studies, it's amazing. Science has proven it amplifies energy and it retains memory. So check it out. Do some quartz, some crystal gridding, some working with some crystal grids, and meditate with some crystals as well. Just work with crystals in general. You'll be surprised what you'll find. And number 8, the 8th way to celebrate this wonderful time of the year is by singing and dancing. If you can, around a bonfire. If you can't, just around drums and have a great time. Sing and dance, celebrate, and feast. Just really have a wonderful time of celebration and gratitude and honoring this time of the year and the harvest and the sun and the earth. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, give it a share, comment, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Wildcraft Wellness, and don't forget to hit the notifications button to be updated for the next video of the Wheel of the Year and more videos to come. I hope you have a wonderful day, and blessed be.